Guys, it's your flower girl, Shelly. Okay, so I wanted to show you what I've been working on last couple days. So, as you've probably seen, or may have seen, I should say, in prior videos, I've been growing from seed a variety of things. I have flowers, I have vegetables. There's a reason why I call them vegetables. I'll go into that another time. But this here, look at this. This is a lemon cucumber, and holy schmoly, this thing has just gone berserk. I mean, it loves this environment. What I've done is, to start them, I just put the seeds on a damp cotton ball or cotton something. These happen to be cotton balls, and they were in the cup without this compost in here and with the lid on it, and they just started germinating like crazy. This is, let's see, what's the date today? Well, actually, I can't remember when I did these. Around the first week of April, actually. They're just going absolutely nuts. They love this environment. What I've done, though, is I have made my own compost the last couple years. Well, several years, but I'm using 2 years ago's because it's ready now. And I'm just filling these cups and then putting whatever it is that I'm growing right on top of them, because as you can see, I'm going to take this guy out. I'll just lift it up. You see all those roots? I mean, they're just sprawling up on, sprawling around up on the top there. And eventually this is going to get too tall for its temporary container. So what I've done on some others is I just put the compost just straight in the bag, labeled what it is, and then put the seed that started germinating just right inside the bag. These hold enough air for them to breathe for a while, and every day almost every day I open these up to let them breathe, get more air, and then at night I seal them back up. So that is the second portion of what I've been doing. And let's see. So I have this container and this container transferred into the new to the added system that I'm doing. And like I said, these are all labeled according to what they are. Now, back to the vegetables. Well, and actually some of these flowers too. I'm not 100% sure that all of what I'm growing are heirlooms. And if, whether they are or not, I like to harvest the seed and then replant those seed from the mother plant, whatever it is that I'm originally growing. I take seed from that, replant that the following year to see if it was a hybrid or not. And how I'm able to tell is I can see the differences. Like, I don't have a picture of that, but one year I grew petunias that were a hybrid. I collected and harvested the seed from those, replanted those, and they came up like three different colors. So that to me was my indicator that those were a hybrid, other than the fact that I already knew that. But what I like to do is I like to see what it is that humans put together to create this new whatever it is that they're trying to create. I like that because it's entertaining for me, and I just like to figure out what it is, what the original goal was, because a lot of times, from my understanding anyway, is that hybrids are created to enhance features or characteristics, embellish what was already there. Anyway, I like to break it back down just to see for myself what it is. It's just another fun thing for me to do, other than everything that I'm doing right here anyway. It's just an added bonus for me. I love it. So what I've also done is I am taking, and that's why these are separated into these two containers, because what I'd like to do and am doing is I'm taking photos, not through the, some of these I've taken pictures through the bag itself just because they're getting harder to take back out without damaging or harming them in any way. I mean, these are my babies. I gotta take care of them, right? So, and the goal for that is to help you guys, if you guys grow any of these, just to visually see what it is that you're looking for when they start germinating and start coming up out of the ground or wherever it is that you guys are planting them, just an identification for you to help you distinguish what you planted versus weed seed that may be coming up. I will say though that there are some real tricky weed seed that if you planted something, I'll just give you an example. A few years ago I planted catch fly, none so pretty, it's in the silene family, and there was a weed that came up near where she was originally planted, and it looked almost identical to the catch fly, other than the fact that it grew a bit taller than what the catch fly does. And I really inspected that. I was like, wait a minute, is this the plant? And it just blew the seed over, but no. So be aware that there are some seed that weeds and seed that are very similar and try to mimic an actual flower. I mean, it's brilliant, actually. It's absolutely brilliant. But so, and then back to this impatient / vinca question mark. This may actually have been tagged correctly because there's different sizes of impatient. So I won't know until she blooms and I'm actually really growing her to see if I mismarked it or it is an actual impatient, just a different variety. So I will get back to this later as the season progresses, but I'm just trying to help you guys as much as I can for the whole process, you know, from germinating to, you know, growing this is how I do it. I'm not saying that you all have to do it the way that I do it. This is just something that I've been doing for years and has worked for me specifically. Although I will say I've not grown in these bags before, so this is new for me, but it's working, so I'm going to keep with it. This is salvia, and look at how cute those are. I mean, they're just adorable. And what I've done, like I said, is I just put a little bit of compost at the bottom of this. The roots will eventually go through and have gone through the cotton ball down, and they will just start going in the compost itself rather than like this. I was too late to put this in compost. Actually, what I'm going to do with this, the cucumber lemon, is I'm going to put that guy back. I'm going to do just what I did with these vegetables and just put the compost down at the bottom of the bag. I'm going to take this out of the cup because she's getting almost too tall for this bag. So that'll lower it as well, and then I'll be able to cover the root system. That way I don't lose her at all. And this is an heirloom, by the way. And oh god, if you've never grown lemon cucumbers, I mean, this is amazing. I took her out of the original cup, and as soon as I did, boy, I got a waft of her scent, which is lemon scented. It's amazing. I love it. I love it so much. But anyway, so I'm going to put the compost down at the bottom of the bag. I'm going to fill a little bit more in there and then just put her back down and then try and cover those root systems because I don't want to lose her. If it gets too much air, then she's going to die. So that is what I've been playing with. Oh, I love it. And I just wanted to share that and show you guys. So my camera battery kind of went, ran down. So I only have these two trays worth of identification. But as I progress here, I'm going to go through all the rest of what is growing and snap pictures of the foliage so that you know what to look for and what it looks like when it starts growing. Anyway, that's what I have for y'all today, and I will catch you on the next one.